for another edition of Coaches in Cafes Having Coffee. Today we come to you from one of our fantastic partners of Islanders Athletics, Atomic Omelette and Grill. I want to thank Mike Van Sickle, his sister Dana, everybody here for their accommodations. We're joined by Steve Greene, head coach of Islander Volleyball today. First time for Coach to be on the cafe show, and I know you're a tea guy. You are a tea guy, big time. So I know that they appreciate you being here, and we do as well. Tell me a little bit about what we do like in the show here is we talk a little bit about the season. We talk a lot about you. We talk a lot about your family, a lot of the choices that you made that got you here to Texas A&M. And I'll start with that in particular. Before you came here, you were at Texas A&M, elite assistant at Texas A&M, and it's a great opportunity, a fantastic job at a high major program. But what's the difference between that type of job and running your own program?
There's a lot. It's a learning process when you're running your own program. I'm now in year four here, and I'm learning something new, each season. And everything's kind of a challenge. I think my first couple of years you're trying to define yourself as a head coach and who you want to be, and you tend to look back to previous coaches you've had and try to emulate some of the things that they've done. When I was at Texas A&M, Lori Corbelli, ran that program with just the utmost class, and it was just run really, really well. And I try to look up to her and try to emulate that a little bit. Here, I think I'm trying to do that, and it just takes time to build it. Part of that is me and building the culture, and part of that is the recruits and who we bring in. And now in year four, we really have it going full speed.
What was some of the best advice you ever got from maybe one of your previous head coaches leading into this position?
Lori Corbelli, she told me, I got this position here. She said, just be yourself, and things will, do the things that matter to you, and it'll take care of itself in the long run. And then I've got a couple other mentors from the past, Tom Pestalozzi, who's a community college coach in California and the Hall of Fame there, and he said, you're a great person, and you're a good leader, and you just have to take care of the student athletes that you have. You take care of them, everything will be fine.
I'll tell you one thing, it's been an interesting ride now. You came in on fire, we had that phenomenal team, and then we had a little up, a little down, but it looks like we're really back on the up again. You had a great squad this year, although they started conference a little bit slow, 1-3, but you had a heavy lineup early. They've been playing exceptionally well. Is this team just one of those teams that really has just grown as the season progresses?
Definitely. I mean, we're still a fairly young team. We only have two seniors, Madison Greene and Eloise Van Beltoven. But we're 9-4 in conference right now, looking forward to the conference tournament. And, I can honestly say that we've gotten a little bit better each match. We're improving our defense as the season goes on. Our blocking keeps getting better and better. And those are kind of the two weaker points when the season began for conference. And our offense is still clicking most of the time. And when that happens, I think we're a tough team to beat.
You have a couple of people that, of course, support you, and that's Justin Wong and Sasha Karlov. Tell me about them and why they fit in your system.
Justin and Sasha are great assistant coaches. They balance out really well. Justin Wong, he's a very calm demeanor. He articulates things really well about the direction we want to go. He handles things in match very, very well in that respect. And behind the scenes, he does a ton of work for us. He keeps everything really organized and makes sure we are all in the right place and doing all the right things. I appreciate that a lot. And Sasha Karlov, she is coming off of a really stellar career when she played indoors at Duke and the beach at Long Beach State. This is her first, full-time college coaching job. She did a junior college year, but this is kind of the first NCAA Division I job. And, her competitive spirit has really brought a new dynamic to our team. She's already a great coach, and she's going to be really, really good. She's building to try to be a head coach soon. And I love what she does with the team dynamic and kind of individual player development on a day-to-day basis.
You came to Corpus Christi. You moved here. You took the position. And then all of a sudden, you discovered the island. And that is sanctuary for you now, for you and the family.
Yeah, it's great. When we got offered the position here, it did take a little while to think about it, but it was sort of a no-brainer once we figured out the geography and where we could live and all that. And we live out on the island, right on the water there, and it's awesome for the family. It's you know, we go swimming every day in the canals, and you know, my wife is happy. I've got two little kids, a 6-year-old or 7-year-old now, and a 3-year-old. And he's getting older, and they're loving it, you know. And that's part of what makes Corpus Christi kind of a special city, that, you know, we see the water every day. You can jump in at any time year round, and it definitely makes it. Even when you have a tough day at work or a tough day at home, you know, you just look outside and, you know, you relax really fast.
Coach, I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Steve Greene joining us once again. Coaches in cafes having coffee. Thank you again, Atomic Omelette. Thank you all for joining us. See you next time.